everyone, today we'll be installing Apple CarPlay and Android Auto on the Nissan Navara, year models 2009 to 2014, specifically for the models that have come with factory navigation from Nissan. These models have HD screens built in for the navigation system. These integration modules come from Nifty City. It will sit behind the dash and it will loop with the screen and the head unit that sits behind the buttons here. We will go ahead and go through the installation and then we'll have a muck around with the module. The very first thing you're going to do is pry this off. Let's take off the transmission and then remove the pin, facing it out towards the dash, not towards you. And once you remove the cup holder trim, the transmission, you're going to go ahead and pry this off. I remember to move the transmission down so you can get that leeway to pull out the lower trim. Disconnect all connectors. Remove these two screws here. This next part will require you to remove two side bolts in order to gain access or remove this compartment here, then to allow the dash to be lifted upwards and towards you. So drop the lower part of the trim below the steering in order to get access to a bolt which is just back here. You will need a long sort of tool to reach into that spot. That'll be behind there, and then the other one is on the other side. You just need to remove the two screws to drop the glove box and just to get in from there. I used a tool this length to get in. You can try and find one maybe similar. Once you've removed those two bolts, this will allow you to remove the pocket and the dash going upwards. I've then removed the pocket and it's allowed me to put in some extra pressure to pull out the whole dash. Now, once you remove this dash, please be careful as there are a few connectors at the back of this dash, and be careful not to scratch the screen as well. Some might prefer to completely remove the dash and some might just let it rest just on the transmission there. You only need to tap into two connectors, which is that one and the one below it. So it's on the right hand side of the head unit if it's facing towards you. The speakers, and that one is the power down there. So do not worry about this part. It's only these two here. So I've gone ahead and disconnected both of them. You'll see here that this is OEM and this is Nifty City here, and then put Nifty City back into the head unit. Once you've done it for both, there we go, you'll then go ahead and connect this side to the module. Just to give you an indication of what it looks like, Nifty City to OEM and Nifty City to module. The next part is tapping in with the brown LDVS cable. This must be looped with the brown LDVS sitting behind this screen. You can either go ahead and remove all four screws up there, 1, 2, 3, 4, or you could just go ahead and reach on over and just disconnect it and tap into that one. Now the Nifty City LDVS cable, this one goes to the module. These ones are going to be three-waying with the factory LDVS. Factory LDVS to female Nifty City and then male Nifty City into the screen. Then go ahead and feed the cable down the dash and leave it somewhere for the connection of the module later. So I'm going to remind everyone that it's generally a good rule of thumb to test everything before you put the car back together. So you connect the two power cables, speaker and power cable, to the back of the head unit, loop them with the factory head unit, and then connect the other part to the Nifty City module, and three-way the LDVS cable from the screen and also connect that. Now we need to go ahead and test it. Just hold the back button on the dash, the right hand side one, just hold it, and if it switches over and it's successful, you're good to go. Do remember that you need to connect the audio channel coming from the main harness of the Nifty City module. You need to either connect this sound out to the armrest, okay, and then just click AUX on the dash to change the audio channel to Nifty City. Or if you'd like, you can go ahead and remove that and feed it underneath and have you whatnot do what you can do with that one. But you must connect it to that. Or if you'd like, please contact Nifty City in order to get an audio harness that will keep all your work behind the head unit, so it'll keep it a clean installation. This is the custom audio harness from Nifty City. This plugs into the back of your head unit to keep the installation pretty clean and keep it all behind the head unit. Rather than having to throw the sound out from the Nifty City module main harness all the way to your armrest input, this is to avoid that. So go ahead and connect the sound out to the AUX female from this custom harness, just like that, and then go ahead and connect it to this one here. So loop it with the factory harness and then connect this one to the back of the head unit. Okay, so I went ahead and connected the audio harness. I will go ahead and connect the USB inputs that you can place anywhere in the car, and then remember to connect the auto play dongle to the USB inputs, and then you can hide that anywhere, or you can just leave it by your dash or armrest in there, so you can use a wired Apple CarPlay and Android Auto as well, and to charge your phone. Once you've gone ahead and done that, let's go ahead and find that on here. Tap it, wait a few seconds, and there we are. Once you're happy with it all, you can go ahead and start putting the car back together. Best placement for the module would probably be back here. Set it in a nice place and then put everything back together. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, I'm on the radio station now. I've installed the Nifty City module and we're gonna go ahead and switch over to the Nifty City module. We're gonna hold this back button for 2 seconds and then it switches the display over. Go ahead and go to autoplay. And obviously my phone is connected in the background with Bluetooth. Now you may have noticed that the audio is still on the radio. Just hit AUX to change the audio channel to Apple CarPlay. So the best part is, I get the best of both worlds, right? Let's just say I want to listen to the radio. Right, I'm listening to the radio here, but I also want to follow the navigation inside Apple CarPlay. We'll just go ahead and leave it on this audio channel. Cool. We've switched over the display, and we're still listening to the factory radio. Okay, there we go. Let's go to the factory unit for a second. Let's have a look at the status, average fuel economy, distance to empty. We can go all the other info, check out all the other stuff on the factory unit for Nissan. And obviously this is the same for Infiniti as well. Cool. Cool. And then we'll go ahead and switch again with the display. And then AUX to go back to Apple CarPlay. Reverse cameras, no need to wire any reverse cameras, it all works like normal. Factory reverse cameras will automatically be read and play like normal. Split screen, so you got music, search, maps. Another good thing to note is climate control. For the Nissan and Infiniti vehicles that have climate control built into the vehicle, it'll display over Apple CarPlay like normal. Navigate me to the closest petrol station. I'm in a Nissan Navara today, guys, 2014 model with the factory navigation unit from Nissan. It'll also work on the Nissan Pathfinder with a similar dash, and obviously the patrols as well. Some patrols have this dash, the 2010 models. Head over to Nifty City and you'll see a module for your car there. They do specialize in Nissan and Infiniti, guys, as well, so fully integratable. It's amazing.